Cosa hai fatto, uomo?
Hush now.
Thank you, mister.
I'll see someone. He's right there. You'll be seeing it.
You! Summit belongs to the Blighters!
You have a present right now.
Oh, I'm happy.
There you are. This could be interesting. There's no shortage of firearms.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions. I believe I should re-interrogate a suspect.
He was a good man, very honorable. I'm proud to have served under Colonel Prescott in the 11th Foot Gold Coast Africa. Bullet hole in the clock. That's a new one. It could have already been there when I arrived at Nell. Or maybe it was the second shot I heard. I was on my way here. Heard two shots I did, right at the stroke of noon.
I should return and find out about this.
I've got a bead on it!
Gonna get it now!
I should return and find out about this.
Help! It's murder!
Prescott put that up in memory of the time he led a sortie across the Pra River to outflank Ashanti warriors. Things turned out badly that day.
From what I can gather, Prescott was shot almost exactly at 12 o'clock noon. Apparently, they put the clock there while doing some repairs. It still runs, I notice. The young lads across the street were fooling with a pistol they'd found. A bullet must have gone astray through the wooden fence, hit Mr. Prescott smack in the chest. Bloody unlucky for all concerned. When Colonel Prescott retired from the army, he used his connections and started this munitions factory. He wanted...
Is that a cadaver? Oh!
Murder!
It's been a murder!
Poor dead bugger.
Oh.
revolver underneath the lumberyard window. Don't know where it came from. We stood right there on a mark and shot the target. I went to shoot, but there was a loud bang. I was surprised and missed the target completely. It wasn't me who killed the man. I'm no murderer. We found a revolver underneath the lumberyard window. Don't know where it came from.
Him and me like to insult each other. I was a lieutenant under his command in Africa. I love the army. No one questions you when you wear a uniform. Anyways, every morning when he arrived, we'd call out and joke with each other. Yeah. Well, Prescott led a flanking sortie that went wrong. Lots of casualties. Some men called the colonel a coward, but it were really just bad luck. Anyway, he resigned. To make amends, he offered work at his factory whenever one of us left the army.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
I admit it. I sell stolen rifles and pistols. All very hush-hush. Black market. I brought that gun back from Africa. I was a sniper fighting the Ashanti. I used that gun this morning for Prescott's challenge. It's the only Whitworth we have. I'd never sell it. I made that shot. Early this morning, Prescott challenged me to plug the 12 from my shot. I missed just slow. No one witnessed it. It was too early in the morning.
Saw him each morning as I drove by. Seemed like a good sort. We lost an entire barrel of beer, damn it. I heard two loud bangs, but thought nothing of it. Later, I found a bullet hole in a barrel. Imagine that, a bullet hole. My lad Samuel might know more. He's around back, tossing trash in the river. The poor lad. Fell on my doorstep a few years ago. He's in a bad way, has some sort of malady. Rides in the back while I make deliveries. Hard worker, very determined.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
There was an owl in a barrel. I've got no explanation for that. That's for some sickness I picked up a while ago. Can't remember the name of it. I just drop off beer. Don't pay much attention to people along the way. His goddamn cowardice in Africa got me best friends killed. He should have faced a firing squad.
Very good sleuthing on your part. It's a miracle anyone survived what with all those bullets whizzing about.
Let me be talking. Think about that.
I knew you'd show. My warmest welcome. It's our business to keep London in balance, monitoring shipments by road, sea, and rail. Our biggest problem, the Blighters. If you could rid us of them, I'd be ever so grateful.
It would make London safer.
You find anything that sparkles, it's yours.
I do love a bit of sparkle.
Good haul, boss.
Incoming. I gonna deliver this godforsaken city without protection?
Doing fine, girl. That's a girl.
Yo.
That Nigel's got some wee caper. You should see what's waiting for you at Whitechapel Station. Nigel wants to make up for things, so he got you a gift.
Huh.
Mr. Fry, come have a look at this. Ain't she a beauty?
Oh, well done, Nigel.
Yeah, I nicked it off the gang across town, got them all stewed, and then took it when they was asleep. Here, sir, let me show you. It's jammed. Oh, shit. Move!
Yeah.
Thank you.
I believe it's time to go! job.
I should be going home.
There's one thing I've learned. It's
when
to scarf.
I've had enough of you, girl.
Right, I think it's Dr. Scarpa.
Is it?
I would like a 7-inch flywheel, please.
Hang on a minute. Damn it. I can't get a blessed thing done around here.
Miss Evie! I've done something dreadful! The train won't stop!
Keep your flywheel.
Huh.
Hello?
Should be safe.
No. keeping up.
Come on. Oh my god.
We should be stopped.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Left.
Oh my god.
Quick! The brakes are gone! She's bursting into flame! Fly ground and put out the fires while I fix the brakes!
These fires won't put themselves out.
Where does this bastard thing go?
Keep cropping up. I can't let these fires take hold. Check on the driver.
Oh my god. Okay.
Miss Plum is no longer head of the Southwark Blighters, and they go into this fight leaderless. Rooks have good odds.
Hey,
This borough belongs to us! Show the
face you like a bitch! You want a place to be?
Jacob and Evie Fry. And as of this moment, you all work for us.
Have a good day now.
Thank you.
the street. Please make sure to come again.
5.
Thank you. Come back again, by all means.
Get your... I do hope you change your mind.
Thank you. me again.
What do you want from me? Are you with the police? Are you a copper?
Keep it down.
I don't deserve to hang.
You won't get the death penalty, chap. But you sure as hell can't bail out of a routine arrest for theft.
They'll kill me in there.
Murderers get a bad reputation in prison, Mr. Backus. You stole a couple of diamonds. You'll make out all right.
Meow!
Let's go. Walk on, girl.
Empty-handed? Pity.
Come take a look!
You'd better not do that again!
Thank you.
20 blackbirds baked in a pie.
In a few years, there'll be a job with the Rooks for you.
Yeah. to something.
There you are.
Mind you, I heard they're paying good money at the College of Medicine.
Sorry, boss. Jamie got distracted.
I did I?
Enough. Seen Burb and Cletus this morning. Funds are low.
Someone take care of him!
Settle down.
What do you think you're doing? Unhand me!
The coppers would like a word, Mr. Butler.
You must have the wrong man. I'm innocent. Get me out of here!
Oh. Doing fine, girl. That's a girl.
Feeling a little entitled, was he?
There was trouble.
Stop that trespasser!
What did you see?
Quiet now. Hush.
I haven't done anything, I promise.
What about those two thugs then? And a little conversation about your sister.
I would do it again if she asked. She's one of the most powerful figures in London. She tells me to do something, I do it. In return, she puts food on me table.
You're still breaking the law in the eyes of the coppers.
Do you think it's a crime?
Wait, I think I heard something.
The real menace.
E sim.
Join us, Jacob. We're about to set out to fight the Blighters for the territory.
Mr. Cletus Strain and the Blighters have challenged the Rooks to a fight for territory in Lambeth. Defeat him and the borough's yours. Look, Sharpie's a bit sadistic.
No, but the Blighters!
gentlemen, we are Jacob and Evie Fry. And as of this moment, you all work for us.
Done you wrong, sir. Never, I say.
I see.
Mr. Owen, you are...